Evening. Welcome to the Cigar Cabin, home of great cigars and fine whiskies. My name's Des, this is episode number 9. If you've not checked out any of our other episodes, make sure you check them out. Make sure you subscribe to my channel. It's free to do. And like I say, if you can share the passion that I do for cigars, or you want to learn how to maybe smoke cigars, or just the routine that I have when it comes to smoking cigars, make sure you hit that subscribe button, share, follow, give me comments and everything, just to support my channel. So, last week I did the Camacho Robusto cigar, weren't a very good one, didn't enjoy it, and I think you could tell with the video it's a bit flat. So I'm hoping this week I have chosen a better cigar, one I've had a long time ago now. So I'm going to do this cigar, so let me just get it for you. This is a humidor. We've never really looked at it from this angle, so let me find it. No. Here we go. So, the cigar in question is the Olde World Reserve Rocky Patel Maduro Toro cigar. It's a box press cigar. Now, looking at this cigar, it's beautiful. It looks a great colour. It's got like a decorative sleeve at the foot of the cigar. It feels great. Feels great. Now, I can't really remember the taste I got off this cigar. This has been probably about 3 or 4 years ago since I smoked one of these. So let's get this unwrapped, get it out of the cellophane wrapping, to give you a bit of an idea of what I'm getting from it. So a box press cigar, get rid of that. Wow, very sweet tobacco by the smell of it. Smells divine. Very, very dark looking cigar. The decorative bands, always quite nice. You know what I go for now, it's the good looking cigars, the bit of work that's gone into it. Now, this feels so nice. It looks a great colour, very dark. It's a mild cigar. It's a 6.5-inch cigar with a 52 ring. So it's really sweet. Honestly, it smells absolutely great. When we get into this cigar, it's not very veiny. There don't seem to be any blemishes on the wrap. Very tight wrap by the feel of it. So let's take this bit of decorative paper off the bottom. Wow. I mean, if you could see this cigar, it's just so flat on the bottom, beautiful. Let me just show you that. Band, very, very simple, easy, but it looks a phenomenal cigar. So I'm going to get this cut. I'm going to use a guillotine cutter. This is a double cap cigar. You can see it. I don't really want to punch this cigar, but I'm going to do the guillotine cut on this, and let's get this roasted. So again, just check the cap, get the guillotine ready, get the cigar in, over the ashtray. Give it a cut. Wipe off any residue. Then do a cold draw. Seems to draw quite nicely. Get some lovely taste off this leaf. And I love the darkness. When you get it wet on the top, it just looks great. So I'm really excited about this cigar. I can't wait to get into it again. From what I can remember, I did enjoy the last one that I had of these. So let's get this roasted. And as I've said before, the lighter of choice is the butane lighter. Mine's a 4-burner. So let's get this started. So again, just roast the end of the cigar. That's if you're new to the channel. If you already watched some of my episodes, you'll see exactly how I do it. But just if you've not watched any of the episodes before, this is how we get a cigar lit. So we've just roast the end. Really simple. You could just go around the edge just to seal it a little bit. See, this is the problem with not checking your products. So, I'm going to come back in a second. I need to get some fuel back in this lighter. Join me in a second and I'll get this toasted again. Live shows, unfortunately, so bear with me. Right, firstly, I'm going to apologise about that, but I'm only human. I've made a mistake. It's one of those things. So, we have the lighter back working. So let's get this roasted. So let me just leave where I went from before. Just roast the end of the cigar. See it glow a little bit, it smokes, then bring it to the mouth. With a box press, it's a little bit harder to twizzle, but it's a simple thing. So yes, so that's lit really well. That looks all the way around. It looks fantastic. So let me give this a couple of draws and see what I get from it. Feels great in the fingers. It looks a great looking cigar. I mean, I do like the darkness of a cigar, especially when it's this dark. Feels great in the fingers. Draws really well, very smooth. So let's give it a couple of draws and see where we get from it. So straight away, I'm getting like an oily, smooth, silky taste in the mouth. There's a coffee. I can taste a lot of coffee in it. I just love the look of this cigar. Now, if you've not smoked a cigar, you can't have anything better looking than this. I mean, it feels great. The coffee taste that I'm getting, smooth, silky, very oily wrapper, which is oily leaf, which is a great, very moist. Smokes so well. And if you've watched any of my other channels, part of the passion for me with cigars is the actual smoke, what I get from it, what it delivers. This is bringing back memories from the last time I had a cigar. So it's rich, it's velvety, it's a medium cigar, which is great. So, you know, if you're new to cigars, try one of these. It's great, and especially when the starts to draw down, the colour of the ash contrast against the dark leaf, it's fantastic. So nice, so much different to the Camacho that I had last week. Didn't enjoy that one at all, and I felt like as if the video was a bit flat from the review. And it makes such a difference when you get a nice cigar. This, the taste I'm getting, like definitely lots of coffee. I'm getting some cocoa, getting some wood, earthiness on it. Fantastic, really nice cigar. Rocky Patel are one of my favourite cigars, so my hat goes off to Rocky Patel because they do deliver some fantastic cigars. Very smooth, the smoke is light, it coats the inside of your mouth, the smoke does, and it just delivers such a beautiful taste. The burn, it's a bit uneven, but that will sort itself out. That's just down to the veins on the cigar, or just the leaf. It's fine, nothing to worry about. It'll rectify itself. So if you're... if you're new to cigars, or never tried one, it's difficult at the moment, I'm finding, because I've struggled doing purchases online. I love nothing more than going to my local shop in Solihull and rummaging through all the different cigars. At the moment, I have to make do with what I've got. I really struggle to decide what cigars to purchase. I just love the shop of it, going there, looking at the cigars. I normally come around with about probably about 5 or 6 cigars, maybe a lighter, maybe an ashtray. Sometimes, more often than not, I come away with a bottle of whiskey. But that's the excitement for me. As I say, we're going through this coronavirus at the moment, which is making it very difficult. So I'm just going to do with what I've got, and hopefully I can get to a cigar outlet, my local, and just purchase some new cigars and do some great reviews. But this, it's been in my humidor for probably 6-7 months now, and it's just immaculate. I mean, it's smooth, sweet tobacco. I think I'm gonna really enjoy this cigar. So again, it's the Olde World Reserve Rocky Patel Maduro Toro cigar, box press. So I'm gonna get down this cigar. I'm gonna get to about a quarter of the way down. I'm really gonna enjoy this, I know I am. So join me and I'll tell you if there's any new flavors I get from this cigar. And I'll tell you a little bit about what I've been doing the last week or so since the last video. So join me, quarter of the way down. Right, so you join me quarter of the way down this amazing cigar. This cigar is producing some of the best flavors and tastes I've ever come across. There's cocoa, lots of coffee, woodiness, earthiness. It's silky, it's smooth, it's dark. The ash is drawing down, a bit uneven, but the construction of this cigar is phenomenal. It's rich, it's tasty, it's a fantastic taste in the mouth. I take a draw and it's just so easy and effortless, which is what you want in a cigar. Such a fantastic cigar, it's just beautiful. I am going to lose the ash shortly because I always seem to drop it on myself. So a little bit about this week. One thing that I've been very happy about, I play golf. So I love a cigar when I'm playing a round of golf. So, you know, I think of the golfer, Juan Angel Jimenez. He plays and he smokes a cigar, very open about it. I don't know if he's frowned upon, but I do get the odd weird look when I'm at the golf course. But it's what I love to do. So there's two really passionate pastimes that I have, and I can do it at the same time. Leave some comments in the section and just let me know if you play golf or you where you have a smoke, where you find it most enjoyable. You know, I love being in here. I love it on a golf course, you know, wherever. I go down the cemetery. I love it when the cigar is fantastic. This is great. So like I said to you, the flavors I'm getting is cocoa, woodiness, leather. I'm getting a leather taste on it. It's a very oily wrapper. Very silky and smooth, rich tobacco. Fantastic. So I'm going to lose this ash here. And by the way, if you're thinking, I had an all right round after nearly 8 weeks of not playing golf. So I've been doing a lot of cigar smoking. But it was enjoyable. Just let me know what you've been doing in this current lockdown. I mean, it has been difficult. I've been taking Big Reg for a walk. We haven't seen him. But like I say, when the production gets back to normal, when Prep Hub can come and, you know, assist behind the camera, then we'll get Reggie back on board. You know, I'm sure you're missing him, probably more than me. I need me haircut. I mean, it's as long as it's ever been. It's crazy. I was wearing a hat the last few times just to cover what a mop it's become. So all those kind of things. So, you know, hopefully we'll become, well, it'll get normal again, and we'll be back doing the normal things that we were used to. So I'm going to take this cigar. It's going quite quick, actually. This has been, I started this, it just turned, well, it's nearly 20 past 8 now, and I started this just before 8 o'clock, and we're almost already getting to the halfway mark of this cigar. So I'm going to leave you at the moment. I'm going to have a little puff on this cigar and give you a feedback when I get to halfway down. Join me halfway down. Right, so join me three quarters of the way down this cigar. It hasn't failed to impress me. The burn has been really straight. The ashes fell off literally moments ago. I mean, have a look at that. I'm hoping that's in good focus. So I'm going to take the band off and tell you some of the taste I'm getting from this cigar. Let's just find the lip on this band, which is just here. It should come off fairly easy, I'm hoping, as I'm struggling to pick the thing off. There it is. Just get the little lip and just take it away. Great. Let me just put that there. Let me just show you the band. Very simple, nothing extravagant, but he had the little decorative sleeve at the foot of the cigar, which was a nice touch. So that's the band. So the taste I'm getting from this cigar, so I'm getting leather, I'm getting lots of cocoa towards the foot of this cigar. It's beautiful. I mean, smooth, silky, oily, rich. The smoke is thick and flavoursome. It's great in the mouth, it's great on the lips. This is right up there. So if you're gonna look at purchasing a cigar online, because obviously it's difficult to go to the shops, you can't purchase one of these. So it's the Rocky Patel. It's the Old World Reserve Cigar, Maduro Toro, box press. Fantastic. So I'm this end of the cigar cabin, so let me talk to you about this end of the cigar cabin. I've got two tub chairs. I've got one here and I've got one there. They're great. You can just sit back, take, just relax. Just look at the smoke from this. I mean, it's fantastic. I've got my humidor here that's full of all my cigars. I've got another little humidor just underneath with some other cigars in there. I've got my whiskies here. So I've got, this is the MGM Grand, it's a rum. When I went to the MGM Grand in Las Vegas in 2013, untouched, unopened. I just think it just looks great. Maybe one day I'll open it. I've got my Yamazaki on top of the humidor. I've got my Curdu behind that. And just on the shelf here, I have my Jack Daniels. It's a single barrel. I've got Blatnock, which is a Lowland single malt Scotch whiskey. I've got Hibiki. I've got Flor de Cana, which is an 18-year-old rum. I've got Ardbeg, which is a 10-year-old. I've got Cigar Reserve, which is a fantastic, that is a cognac that goes beautiful with cigars. I've got Dalmore, and I've got the proper 12 at the top corner. And I've also got another Cigar Reserve cognac here. So this is the other end of the cigar cabin. Not really done much from this end, but it's really nice, it's comfortable, it's easy. But this cigar, back to this cigar, it smokes really well. It's more cocoa taste than normal now. At the beginning there was coffee, but I'm getting a certain amount of spice now. And always the best part of the cigar for me, this is, it smokes so well. As you can see, the level of smokiness from that is just fantastic. Now that, from that one alone, it was really earthy, a really beautiful taste. I get the cocoa, which is nice, a little bit of coffee in there, but it's so smooth, such a great looking cigar. The ashes funneled a little bit, but again, it's just running really well. I'm really enjoying this cigar. Get a bit bunged up as well, I don't know where that's come from. So what I want you to do is I'm going to probably come back a little above another probably 15 minutes. I should be down to where my fingers are then. And I'll let you know if there's any other taste I'm getting from this cigar. But I pretty much think that I've had everything in this cigar. It's really enjoyable. So take a look at one of these. Rocky Patel, in general, produce a great cigar. So join me in about 10, 15 minutes, because this is going quite quick. This is 45 minutes now, this cigar. So it don't take no time. And it's getting away from the stuff that's been going on. This is what I love about it. It's getting away from everything that's gone on in that this week. It just takes me away. People go fishing, I go golf, have a smoke. People have their own voices. This is mine. Look, if you've not tried it, go and get a cigar, give it a try, watch one of my other episodes, and it explains how you start and, you know, experience what I'm experiencing. So join me a little under 10, 15 minutes from now, and I'll go through exactly what I'm getting. So join me then. Right, you join me almost getting to the end of this cigar. It's been fantastic, really enjoy. Starting to get a bit of heat on the fingers now, but it holds so well. The flavours again have not changed. I've got spices, cocoa, bits of coffee now. The cocoa's overpowered the coffee. It's rich, it's velvety, it's smooth on the lips. It's a very oily wrapper. The leaf is fantastic. Its form has been really nice. Really enjoyed this cigar. So I'm gonna have myself a little tot of whiskey. So I'm gonna try, I've never opened this whiskey before. It's still smoking incredibly. So I'm gonna just put this down. So I'm gonna try the Dalmore 12 year old single malt whiskey. I've not tried this before. So this is from the Northern Highlands of Scotland, from the Dalmore distillery. So where's my glass? Here we go. So I'm gonna give this. Do you just love that sound of opening or pouring the first part of a bottle of whiskey? It's just glugs, it's fantastic. So I'm getting citrus, orange. Wow, smells amazing. Let me just put this down. So with the Dalmore, it looks fantastic. I mean, the bottle is unreal. With the stag on it, it looks fantastic. Never tried the Dalmore whiskey, so let's give that a try. Just put that back up there, excuse me. The aroma is fantastic. I always love trying the very first whiskey. So here we go. So, very citrusy. I'm getting some orange notes on there. I'm also getting a bit of chocolate. Take a bit of this cigar, because it's always nice to know when they do match. Do you know, this cigar has been like this all the way through. I haven't had to touch it, I haven't had to, you know, get the lighter back on it. I've not had to, it's just smoke straight away. I put it down for a minute or so and it's just come straight back to life again. The smoke is incredible. And when you take a sip of whiskey with a cigar, it just cleanses the palate. It's fantastic. This Dalmore is really nice. That's the 12-year-old Dalmore single malt Scotch whiskey. It's very citrusy, orangey. It's a fantastic whiskey. And it's really smooth. really smooth when you take the drink. It doesn't burn, it cleanses the palate, it's fantastic. So I'm going to review on this cigar. So it's not failed to deliver. It's been fantastic. I've really enjoyed it. So if I'm to review this out of 11, I'm going to give this a 2 out of 11. So 2 being Winston Churchill. A fantastic cigar. Go out and purchase it. So on that note, make sure you check out our website, www.thecigarcabin.com. Check out my Instagram and also check out my Twitter. Also, let me get me to this 200 subscribers. Support the channel for the chance of winning the proper 12 whiskey and something else I'm going to throw in. But support the channel. Press that subscribe button. On that note, stay safe. See you Sunday.